you. Let's start today's session. Now, in the previous session, we started with the topic inheritance, right? What do you mean by inheritance? Then benefits of inheritance. Then we discussed about different types of inheritance. Okay, now we'll take some examples of it associated. Few examples to you to identify its type. Suppose I have written class bank and then class account bracket bank. Means account class is derived from bank class. So this will be an example of, yes guys, no, quickly, it should be a very quick answer. Class bank, class, pardon,
parent child.
So it is which type of inheritance? Single inheritance, right?
Yeah.
When there is one parent class, one child class, so it's called as a single inheritance. Another example, like class college, class science, which is derived from class college, and class student, which is derived from class science, means class A, then B derived from A, and then C derived from B.
Multi-level
inheritance.
Yes, sir.
ठीक है? This is another example, like class tours, class ticket, and then class booking. ठीक है, which is derived from tours and ticket.
Multiple,
yes. One child class derived from more than one parent class. When one child class is derived from more than one parent class, then it is called as a multiple inheritance. Right? So tours class means you have selected your package, whatever, right? Then ticket means railway ticket, air flight, then it's return ticket, whatever. So from this class and this class, final it becomes your booking. Okay? This is another example, like class college, then science derived from college, engineering is also derived from college, arts is also derived from college. Means science, engineering and arts, all three are types of college. Getting? When more than one child class derived from same parent, then we'll call it as I gave an example also last time. I said that we people are also part of it. Like the entire universe information also is organized in that form. It's called as
diamond.
Diamond will come in hybrid. Diamond will come in hybrid situation.
Okay, sir.
Right?
Is it multiple, like?
It is single inheritance, right? One to one.
How come single? Good evening, Vrishali.
Good evening, sir.
There are multiple child class derived from. Multiple is when there is one child class derived from more than one parent class, but there is one common parent and from that many child classes are derived. How come you forgot the types? All the types I have given you. A is also, this B is also derived from A, C is also derived from A, D is also derived from A. So all three are going to get the common features, but they will have their own. These three are called as siblings, brothers and sisters. So brothers and sisters have their own quality, but they all have the common quality from their parent. This is called as, it exhibits a tree structure. The tree,
hierarchical
yes, correct. It's called as a hierarchical inheritance. Getting? And this is the last one. Bank, personal, these are the two classes. Bank, branch is derived from bank. An account is derived from personal and branch. Bank, then there is personal, then branch is derived from bank, and then account is derived from this both. You can call this type of inheritance as
multi-level.
How come? Just now she gave an example of diamond.
Diamond.
Hybrid.
Huh, yes. And I told that diamond comes in which type?
Multiple.
Diamond comes in which type?
Hybrid.
Hybrid. Hybrid.
Clear? So this is also an example of hybrid. Like you can say this is single inheritance and this is multiple. This is multiple. A is derived from two parents, so it's multiple. This is single inheritance. So when there is more than one type of inheritance, getting online classes, that's the issue. You cannot concentrate on one place. So when there are more than one type of inheritance involved, then we call it as a hybrid inheritance. Yes or no? Hope I had told you all this thing last time. So even diamond problem also come in hybrid only. Why? Because there also more than one type of inheritance are involved. If you see the upper part, so it's a hierarchical inheritance. If you see the below part, it's multiple. So multiple and hierarchical both are involved, therefore it is a hybrid. Here also, here there is a multiple inheritance, single inheritance. So single and multiple both involved, therefore it is hybrid inheritance. Getting? Okay, I hope you are understanding. Then quick, some examples of single inheritance we'll take. Okay, just quickly I'll give an example. Your class A, in that I have defined one function f. F is a function of class A. Just a debug statement I have put. This is just a debugging statement just to check whether it has gone in that function or not. Then class B, it is derived from A. The one child class derived from one parent class. The class B derived from A, and B has defined its own function G, but B can access this F also, and that is inheritance. Yes or no? That is the reason we go for inheritance, because in inheritance, if you are not able to reuse the parent in child, then what's the use of doing inheritance? Yes or no? Like when parents are giving birth to the child, and now then parent have made lot of properties, then so many things, they have purchased lot of house, then gold, then diamond, so many things, mutual funds and shares and everything, and all that things, if they are not available to their child, then what's the use, getting, of giving birth to that child, right? The same concept is in programming. What is the use of creating this child class from this parent if child is not able to access anything of parent? Getting? So it has to. So B will be able to access G also and F also. Do you agree with me? If I create an object of B class, तो कैन दैट बी ऑब्जेक्ट एक्सेस एफ एंड जी बोथ?
यस सर.
क्लियर? दैट इज इनहेरिटेंस. ओके, सी यू ओ इक्वल टू बी. तो आई हैव क्रिएटेड वन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ क्लास बी. यू नो हाउ टू क्रिएट ऑब्जेक्ट इन पाइथन, जस्ट क्लास नेम एंड राउंड ब्रैकेट. तो ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ बी क्लास इज क्रिएटेड. नाउ कैन दिस ओ एक्सेस इट्स ओन जी एंड कैन इट एक्सेस एफ ऑफ पेरेंट एज वेल? सी यू ओ डॉट एफ ऑल्सो इज एक्सेबल एंड ओ डॉट जी इज ऑल्सो एक्सेबल. डू एग्री विथ मी? Now
Yes,
some
sir.
may ask like, okay, after creating object you are accessing the methods of parent also and the child also. Okay, Miss child also has done its own. So it will access its own behavior, but it will access the parent behavior also. Right? Okay. Can we call that F and G? Yes. Indirectly also you can call. Here you are directly after creating object. But indirectly within G, you can access that F. Is possible. How to do it? All provisions I'll give you. See here. I'm creating class A and just one function F I am adding, in which just one print statement, I am in is F, suppose. This is just a debug statement. Then I'm creating one more class B, which is derived from A. In that also I'm defining one method G, and in that one debug statement I am in B's G. Okay? Then I'm creating an object BB, small b equal to capital B. So B is the name of the object. Can now B access F? Yes. And can B access its own G? Yes. Is it right? See, if we compile it, is it printing appropriate? A is F is also accessible and B is G is also accessible. Now, as I said, like indirectly means this F I want to call here. What all different ways are there? Okay, I want to access this F here. So can we call it? Yes, you can call it. Just you have to write self dot F. Okay, self dot F. Actually, when you say self dot F, so it is first going to search that F in its own class. So will it search F in B class? I wrote self dot f and round bracket. So actually it is going to search this f where? In its own class, B class. But in B class there is no f. So it will go and search in the parent class, which happens in our real life also. Every time we don't go directly to the parent, first we try to see that, okay, is that functionality possible by us? And if we are not able to do it, then we go to the parent. Okay, so is this F first searched in B class? Yes. If not found in B, then it will go in A. And then if in A it is found, then it will access A function. So this is also possible. Now see here, in B I had called, in B's G I had called is F. So that is also printed, then it come back, and then this is printed. Therefore this output has come twice. Okay, this is one way, self dot f bracket. There is another way also, you can write like this, a dot f and then pass self to it. This is also a valid way. Okay guys, please remember, this is also a valid way. You can write parent class name dot method and then pass self. See, you'll get still the same output. Okay, so hope it is clear, right? Yes or no? Now related to inheritance, they have given one function called is subclass. Like we have one function called is instance. Is instance is just to check whether the object belongs to that class or not. Same way to check whether this sub is the subclass of this sub, that is super. Clear? So sub and sup that we have given. So if this subclass is the subclass of this superclass, it will return true. Otherwise, false. See, returns true if the given subclass sub is subclass of the superclass sup. Clear? And one more function which we have already studied in chapter 1 during data types. When I started topic data type, so that time three important library functions I taught you. One library function was ID, then type. Remember or not?
Yes, sir.
And that time is instance. So is instance is just to check whether this object is an instance of this class directly or indirectly also. It is an object of this class or any of its subclass also. Like your object is object of B and you have written A. So it's okay. It will work because indirectly it is derived from that A. So returns true if OBJ is an instance of the given class. And if it is not instance of that class, it will return false. Okay. Like in this example, we will print is subclass. And I am giving B comma A. In our case, it will give true. Is instance B A if I am writing. Okay? And we will run it. Is it giving in both case true? Yes. Though B is a object of B class, small b is a object of capital B. But capital B is derived from A. So indirectly it belongs to that family. Is your object belonging to that A's family? Yes. So as it belongs to that family, it gives true. Getting?
Sir, in the is subclass method, every class will
function.
Have, sorry, in this function, every class will have its super parent as object, right?
Yes.
So in that scenario also, we can use
check, no?
Yeah.
Yes. Like if I'm writing print is sub
b comma
object,
capital,
still it will give true.
Capital B,
no, so b is a object, no, we have to check whether right what
yeah.
You're saying is right. Okay, so ultimately it is coming to that family only, no?
Yes sir,
correct,
got it.
Okay, so I hope you got it. Next, another example of multiple inheritance. Now, multiple inheritance meaning when one child class is derived from more than one parent class. One child class is derived from more than one parent class. Here we haven't yet come to overriding concept. Like some people may ask, like because those who have already worked a lot in object-oriented programming, they might ask me question. Okay, here the name is F, so can the child class also have a function with the name F? Parent class A is having one function with the name F. So can the child class also have a function instead of G, F name only? Yes.
Yes.
You can. So if the child class function name is also F, so then that concept we call it as
overriding,
which is part of polymorphism only. Okay, so it is overriding. So I'm coming to that topic separately. For time being, we'll assume the method names are different. We'll take an example of multiple inheritance. Now, multiple inheritance meaning when there are more than one parent class. Means one child class derived from more than one parent class. Okay. I'll keep all this in files. Whenever you want, when the course get over, if you want all these files for your reference, you can take from me. See here, I've created one class A. Then I'm adding one method F in that class A. Just one debug statement I'm putting. I am in is F. Then I'm creating one more parent class called B. It is also not derived from anyone. In that, I'll add one function g. Again, in that, I'll put one debug statement. I am in b's g. Okay? And then I'll come to class c, which is derived from a and b. So when I create one class c, which is derived from a and b, more than one parent, this becomes which type of inheritance?
Multiple.
Multiple.
Clear? So this is going to be multiple inheritance. Now, in this also, you can define its own function h. Okay? Now, in this h, can I give call to a's f, b's g?
Yes, sir.
Right or no? And how to give call to that a's f, b's g? So there are two ways, I told.
Self.
One, you can write self dot f, self dot g, and then its own statement, own debug statement, that I am in c's h. Okay, I hope you're understanding. Or the other ways, instead of writing self, you could have written
a dot
in comment I'm writing. A dot f and then pass self to it. Okay. I'll just write in this. Or b dot f and then self.
B dot g.
Yes. G and then self. Then I'm creating one object of C class. Can I create object like this? C equal to capital C round bracket. The object of C class is created. Now I am accessing C dot H. I can access C dot F also. C dot G also. Clear? I have accessed it here now indirectly in H. Inside H, I have given call to F of A. I have given call to G of B and its own code. So indirectly also you can access it. Or directly here also. Here also you can write C dot G, C dot F. Everything is accessible. Okay. But anyway, this is an example of
multiple
inheritance. Can you see this? It has printed F. Then it has gone to B's G. Then it has printed its own debug statement. Clear? Okay, so I hope you got it. See here. So I have created one class A in which there is one function F. Then I have created class B in which also there is one function G. Then I have created class C, which is derived from A and B. So as this one child class is derived from more than one parent class, this itself proves it is multiple inheritance. Do you agree or no? Clear? And now C is having its own H, and in that I am giving call to A's F, then I am giving call to B's G and own code. Okay, then I'm creating object of C class, C dot H. When I give call to C dot H, it will first search F in own class. Search of F will be done in own class, not found. Then it will go to these parents. So it will first go to A parent. In A parent found, it will call it. Okay, then self dot G. Clear? So it will get it in B parent. So it will call that and then own code. Do you agree? Okay. Same way, can we have multi-level inheritance? Multi-level inheritance means when one child class is already derived from a child class. Means its parent is also already a child. Okay. Which is called as an intermediate superclass.
So,
clear?
Huh. In case of multiple, if both the parents are having same method, then we cannot call it from self dot function name, right?
No, you can access it by the class name.
Then we
But
have.
it will access it. It will access, but it will go through that sequence, and whichever it gets first, no, that it will call.
Then
it will do it.
okay, means first
I
it will
guess.
call A
Yeah.
and then B.
It will search in this list. Okay, I'll tell you. But that is again overriding. No?
Right.
Means if the same name is there. See here also, if there is F, you want to say. Isn't it? You want to say that, no?
Yes.
Like
sir.
both parent are having same
Same
name.
method. Yeah.
Huh? So now you want to say that okay, how to access this F and this F. So there is no option with self. Then you have to go with this name only, like this, A dot F, self, and you have to write B dot F and then self.
Got
clear? But only self dot won't work.
Yes.
It will call same function only twice. Getting? I'll tell you that too. Like if you do it this way. Getting? So if you are writing this way, how it will know, na, that take this F from A and take this F from G, because in both place you have written self. So it's not intelligent like us, that it will assume that your intention is take this F from one and this F from one. In both contexts it will give call to the same one, I guess.
Yes, that's why
right.
called on class name.
Clear? So it will search in this list, and in that list whichever class it gets first, it will give call to that one. Getting, no? So this way you have to do self and self. Now if you go it this way, so it will call it from the appropriate one. Now here you have written AF and BF, so it will call from appropriate. It's calling all three.
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay, I'll keep it back to original because yet I have not come to the topic overriding. Now coming to multi-level. So multi-level, I have already told you. Multi-level means when one child class is already derived from a child. Means that child class parent is also a child. Means it itself is again derived from some other parent. So that is called as an intermediate parent class. Their grandparent, parent and a grandchild. That way relation exhibit. Getting? So OP13 I'll give. One example I'll give. Class A, F, I am in A's F. I hope all others are also hearing me carefully. Yes or no? Sahil, Sanjay, Harshal,
yes,
all
sir.
Of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now def G. I'm defining one more function called G. Now indirectly you can call that B inside B is F, you can give call here. Getting? How you can give call, I hope you know. One way is this one, A dot F, pass self, and then print I am in B's G. Then I'm creating one more child class, which is derived from B. So this is called as multi-level. Okay, so A is a grandparent, B is parent, and C is the grandchild. Right? Def H I am giving. In this also indirectly I am calling B's G. Okay. Passing self to it. I am in C's H suppose. Okay. So it's not mandatory that you have to call one method inside another like this. Indirectly. Like A's method you are calling in B's method, then B's method in C's method. Not compulsion. You can directly also call it. Okay. Means directly if I create an object of C class, C equal to C. So can this C access A's F, B's G and C's H.
Yes, sir.
All three it can access. A's F also, B's G also, and C's H also. So C dot F, C dot G, C dot H, all three can be accessed. Or indirectly also you're accessing only, no? If I write C dot H, so it will go to H. In H it will go to B's G. In B's G it will go to A's F. Complete this work, come back, then complete this work, come back and print this thing. Getting? If you run and see, you'll get accordingly output. A's F, B's G, C's H. Right? Okay. Hope it is clear.
So in that self, whose reference has been passed?
Object which is created, the C, C object. You have created first C object, C equal to C. Then C dot H. When you wrote C dot H, is it like this? C dot H and that small c.
Yes.
C dot H and that small c. Small c means that object. Is that C object reference only going to come in self?
Yes.
Clear? And as it's a child object, it's having access to parent also. It's having access to its parent also. Because C is object of capital C. And when you say capital C, so in that not only capital C, capital B and capital A, all three are allocated. So that object is having access to its own part, parent part and grandparent part. All three it can access. Getting?
Yes.
So self, I hope you got it. Whoever is the invoker, its reference has gone in self. Coming to the same example, class A, its own F, class B, its own G, in which I am giving call to A's F. Now you know how the ways are, either by self dot or parent name dot F and then pass self. C in which there is H, and in H we have given call to BG. BG has given call to A's F. Okay, you create an object, give call to H. It's giving all the three debug statement. So already it has come to H. Then in H it went to G. In G it went to F. Did this work, came back, then did this work, came back, and then did this work. Okay, I'm just giving you the alternative way. This is one way, and second way is by the class name. A dot F self, B dot G self, which I in the demonstration I have used this technique. Yes or no, guys? Clear? And I'm creating an object and calling H. Same thing is happening in both case. This side and this side, both side the same thing is happening. Only the difference is here I have revealed the parent class name. I'm using the name of the parent class. I'm using the name of the parent class, which is actually a poorer technique. Means generally they say instead of this, you should prefer this. Why? Because here you are using the parent class name. And with this, the code independency is poor. Code independency meaning, if you make change at one place, you have to make change everywhere. So that is called as code dependency. Code independency meaning, by making one change, it's not leading to many changes. You understanding? Like if one change is going to lead to many changes, then it is code dependency. And if one change is not going to affect anywhere, means if I make one change, then also my code is not going to get affected. So it is code independency. So here code dependency is large. Like suppose from class A, if it becomes class Apple, so in the child class, everywhere you have written A dot, you have to change it to Apple dot. Yes or no, guys?
Correct.
So lot of changes will come. Same way if this B changes to banana. So in this child class, wherever there is B dot, now in this case once only you have used B dot, but it's not necessary, no? In the whole entire class, many time b dot has come. So every place b dot you have to make it banana dot. Clear? So that changes you have to do, which you don't have to do if you use this self word. Why? Because self is generalized referring to that itself. Self is referring to itself. Correct? So using the self code independency is better. Your poor code independency. So generally we should not reveal the parent class name in the child class. A good practice. Getting? Again, those who are C++ programmers, they should know it. Because there was no such provision. There only one option, you have to use the parent class name in the child class by writing to scope resolution, colon, colon. Yes or no? Clear? You might have studied na, C++. So in that, it's like that. Anyway, coming to the another example, that is hierarchical inheritance. Now, hierarchical inheritance meaning when there are many child class derived from one common parent class. One common parent class, and from that one parent only, many child classes are derived. That all child classes are called as siblings. Isn't it? So one example of hybrid also I'll show you. Sorry, hierarchical also I'll show you. See here, class A, this is the root class or parent class. Again, a debug statement. I am in A's F. Okay. Then I'm creating class B derived from A. I'll put its own method. Using PyCharm, this is only the benefit. The coding typing goes very fast because everything is auto-completed. And I'm creating one more child class C, which is also derived from A. Do you agree? Okay. And here also indirectly you can give call to that A's F. A's F and passing self. This is one style or self dot, you know it. In this I am defining one method H in which I am giving call to A's F and print I am in C's H. Okay. But first of all, are you convinced that it is a hierarchical inheritance?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is an example of hierarchical inheritance. Why? Because there is one common parent class. Okay. One common parent class. And from that one parent class only, many child classes are derived. So B is also derived from A and C is also derived from E. Right? Like in your Windows components, so many components you can see. Like button, and then one is a radio button. Okay? Or another is a toggle button. Or you can say another is a blinking button and one is a irregular button. But both are types of button only. So their common parent is button. And from button, then two types of buttons are derived. You might have seen it so many. Like, or you can take one common called as text component. And then one will be a text field and one will be a password field. But password field and text field, both are types of text component only. So many examples are there in which there is hierarchical inheritance. Okay. Now we can create objects of B also and C also. Generally, A won't be involved in object making. Yes or no? Means directly who won't be taking part in object creation? A. Instead, the two child class will take part in object creation. In object making, either B is involved or C is involved, not A directly. Like A will just play the role of a parent. It will act like a backbone class or a base class or a root from which different child classes are made. and objects making who will be involved in object making child class. Getting? Like you have defined one class called shape. Okay, and from that you have made different types of shape. So it can be a triangle, it can be a rectangle, or it can be a circle, but all are different types of shape. Now in object making, shape class won't be involved. Rather, triangle class, rectangle class, circle class, these classes you'll use for creating object. So then you'll say, what is the role? To provide common properties to everyone. Common properties, common behavior. Getting? So all the common behaviors, common properties are just provided by this parent class. Okay. So in this program, can I create object of B class? Can I create object of C class? Both are the child class. So we can create object of child B, child C. And B dot G. Same way. C dot H. Clear? Can both call their own methods? So B's method is G and C's method is H. So both have called their method and are both calling their common parent class method. G is also calling A parent method and H is also calling A parent method. Yes or no, guys? Clear? So I hope you are understanding this example. See ya. Can you see? A is F, B is G. A is F, C is H. Why? Because both are accessing their common parent feature and they have their own features like siblings, as I said now. B and C are brothers and sisters. So their common parent is A. So never parent are biased, no? In at least in India, they are never biased. Getting? So they give equal for their two children, four children, whatever are there. Correct? So A is available to B also and A is available to C also. Okay? So quickly I'll just give you that example. Class A, its own method F. Class B, its own method G, in which it is accessing A parent F. C, its own H, and here also it's accessing A parent F. Is it right? And their own logic. So it is a best example of hierarchical. Is it a hierarchical inheritance? Parent A and two children B and C derived from A. I'm creating B object B dot G. When I give call to B dot G, so is B dot G giving call to A's F? Therefore I am in A's F and then I am in B's G. Same way I'm creating C object C dot H. So is C dot H giving call to A's F? Coming back and then own logic. Clear? Then comes hybrid inheritance. Okay. Now hybrid inheritance meaning when there is more than one type of inheritance involved. Do you agree all of you? When there is more than one type of inheritance involved, then it is called as a hybrid inheritance. Best example is the diamond example. Clear? But in C++, diamond was a problem. This diamond situation was a problem. Do you remember any of you why it is called as a problem? Why it is a problem in that language? And therefore, to overcome this problem, Java-like language didn't allow only multiple inheritance. Like in Java, such inheritance is not allowed only. Multiple means you know, no?
Right.
One child derived from more than one parent. So they just avoided that problem only by removing which type of inheritance only? Multiple. Clear? You are telling me. Right. Due to ambiguity. Ambiguity meaning duplicacy is there. Who is going to get duplicated till D? Means when the information. Yes, exactly. You got it. Clear? तो व्हेन द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए इज गोइंग टू रीच टू डी, करेक्ट? नाउ एज इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल टू बी, एज इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल टू सी, एंड नाउ बोथ इज अवेलेबल टू डी. तो एज इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल टू डी ट्वाइस वाया दिस पाथ ऑल्सो एंड दिस पाथ ऑल्सो. यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग और नो? तो इज दिस ए इंफॉर्मेशन फ्लोइंग टू डी, एज इंफॉर्मेशन फ्लोइंग टू डी वाया बोथ पाथ. क्लियर? एंड यू कैन चेक इट, लाइक दोज हु हैव डन सी प्लस प्लस प्रोग्रामिंग, यू कैन चेक दैट व्हेन यू टेक द साइज ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट, तो ए साइज विल गेट एडेड हियर ट्वाइस, इट इज गेटिंग एडेड ट्वाइस. तो व्हाई? बिकॉज फॉर अस इट लुक्स लाइक हाइब्रिड, बट एक्चुअली दिस ए इज अ रिप्लिका पैरेंट. इन सी प्लस प्लस व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन सच सिचुएशन कम, ए गेट्स रिप्लिकेटेड, इट इज गोइंग टू बी ट्वाइस, लाइक दिस इट इज. फॉर अस वी से इट इज वन, बट इट इज एक्चुअली डुप्लीकेटेड. यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग और नो? इट्स अ रिप्लिका पैरेंट क्लास. दिस सिचुएशन हैपन्स एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रिप्लिका ऑफ ए इन डी, ए रीचेस हाउ मेनी टाइम्स? ट्वाइस, गेटिंग? एंड देयरफॉर देयर इज लॉट ऑफ वेस्टेज ऑफ मेमोरी, मेमोरी वेस्टेज. बिकॉज इफ सपोज देयर इज दिस सिचुएशन, लाइक योर वन मोर ई क्लास, तो इज दैट ए गोइंग टू गेट रिप्लीकेटेड थ्राइस? तो थ्री टाइम्स इट्स गोइंग टू रीच टू डी. यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम. एंड टू ओवरकम दैट, देन सी प्लस प्लस गेव वन सोल्यूशन कॉल्ड वर्चुअल पैरेंट. वर्चुअल पैरेंट मीन्स बोथ ऑफ देम विल फील दैट ए इज माई पैरेंट, बट एक्चुअली इट इज वन, विच इन रियलिटी हैपन्स. लाइक इन रियालिटी वेन देर आर टू चिल्ड्रन, राइट, वन सन एंड वन इज डॉटर, तो बोथ थिंक दैट मॉम इज एक्सक्लूसिवली माइंड, बट एक्चुअली मॉम इज फॉर बोथ. क्लियर? तो मॉम इज वन एंटिटी ओनली, बट शी इज फॉर दैट डॉटर ऑल्सो एंड फॉर सन ऑल्सो, बट दोज टू फील एज इफ मॉम इज एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर मी, नॉट फॉर द अदर. क्लियर? तो इन दिस केस रिप्लिका विल नॉट हैपन. तो वॉट सल्यूशन दे गेव फॉर रिप्लिका नॉट टू हैपन?
वर्चुअल
दे,
कीवर्ड
हाँ, वर्चुअल कीवर्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज वर्चुअल बेस क्लास, वर्चुअल पैरेंट. तो बी एंड सी बोथ विल हैव ए एज अ वर्चुअल पैरेंट, तो दैट टाइम ए वॉन्ट गेट रिप्लीकेटेड, इट विल एग्जिस्ट ओनली वंस. तो पाइथन इज सो इंटेलिजेंट दैट दे आर सेइंग यू डोंट यूज एनी वर्चुअल पैरेंट और एनीथिंग, वी विल ओनली टेक केयर ऑफ इट. ओके? तो इन पाइथन इफ दिस डायमंड कम, ए इज नेवर डुप्लीकेटेड, इट इज सिंगल कॉपी ओनली, देर इज नो रिप्लिका पैरेंट क्लास. मैंने पाइथन डजन हैव ओनली अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रिप्लिका पैरेंट, गेटिंग? बिकॉज इन पाइथन इम्प्लिसिटली ओनली इट इज विच पैरेंट, मीन्स यू डोंट हैव टू राइट एक्सप्लिसिटली. वाइल क्रिएटिंग बी टेल दैट कि ए इज अ वर्चुअल पैरेंट, वाइल क्रिएटिंग सी टेल दैट ए इज अ वर्चुअल पैरेंट, विच वी यूज टू डू इन सी प्लस प्लस. आई एम श्योर दोज हू लर्न सी प्लस दे नो इट, लाइक, करेक्ट? यर यू डोंट डू, पाइथन इट सेल्फ इज गोइंग टू हैंडल दैट. पाइथन सेज व्हेन सच सिचुएशन कम, ए इज गोइंग टू बी सिंगल ओनली, डोंट वरी, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू गेट रिप्लीकेटेड, एंड इन डी इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू रीच ट्वाइस, करेक्ट? एंड यू कैन चेक इट ऑल्सो, आई विल शो यू हाउ टू चेक इट. बिफोर दैट आई विल जस्ट create one simple diamond situation example. OP is a very vast concept. People have given their so many years of programming only for OP. Kidding? Like those who are Java programmers and all, so from years they are working in Java and they have given their entire life's big part in only object-oriented programming. Here we are just learning as one chapter. Okay, so class A, def, and I'll put one function f, I am in is F suppose. Then I am creating child class B which is derived from A, in which I'll put one method G. I am in B's G. Then I'll create one class C which is also derived from A, in which I'll add one method H. I am in C's H. And finally, I'll create one class D which is derived from B and C. Correct? So, is this the diamond situation?
Yes, sir.
Clear? In this, I'll add one method P, suppose, in which I'm giving call to A's F, I'm giving call to B's G, I'm giving call to C's H, and I'm printing own debug statement also D's P. Theek hai? This will do. Getting? I hope it is clear. Then we'll create one object of D class, and then D dot P I'll call. Anyway, D is derived from BC and B and C are derived from A. So is D having access to its both the parent, and is it having access to their common parent also? Means D can access everything from A, then B, and then C. From all these three classes, everything is accessible to D and its own also. Isn't it? See, is it giving call to A's F, then B's G, then C's H, and then own statement? You can check the order in which the method is searched. That is called as method resolution order. You can give call to that method, D dot MRO it's called as. Getting? D dot MRO, method resolution order. Okay, and you can pass self. One way, or self name, small d. One way, or you could have written d dot mro is also valid. Okay. Now you'll say, what does it print? So it prints the list of all the classes in which the search is done. So it will give this way: first D, then B, then C, and then A. D is a child class, then B and C are its parent, and then A. You can print and see that list. There is actually, instead of D dot, okay, so we'll give this way D dot MRO. Then I'll pass that small d. It's a class method only, no? So no need to pass it. And I didn't print it also. It is returning a list, but I didn't print that list. That's the reason no output came. See. Okay, see, can you see the list? In this list, it is showing the sequence. So first it has gone to D, then B class, then C class, then A class, and then object. But suppose if it is not virtual, getting? Which in C++ also similar thing you can trace and see. There you'll see A twice. You're getting? Like D, then B, then A, C, and then A. So A will come twice. Here A is coming once only. This proves that in Python, implicitly it is virtual. means in Python you don't bother about that diamond problem. Whenever such diamond situation come, that common parent is going to exist only once. It is virtual. Virtual means both the child are feeling that A is my parent, but actually it is parent to both. Getting? Means B feels that A is exclusively my parent. C thinks A is exclusively my parent, but actually A is parent to both B also and C also. Okay? Even there is one inbuilt property, D dot double underscore MRO. Such properties, few, four, five properties I taught you. Double underscore dig, double underscore doc, then module, then name. Yes or no? Same way, this is one more. Now, this will just, instead of list, it will print a tuple. But the sequence it will give. See, it prints a tuple, but the same thing. Own class, then its parent class B and C, then its parent A, and then its parent object. ठीक है तो सिंपल एग्जांपल ऑफ हाइब्रिड आई टोल्ड यू क्लास ए क्लास बी क्लास सी बी डिराइव फ्रॉम ए सी आल्सो डिराइव फ्रॉम ए तो टिल नाउ इज इट एन हायरार्किकल इनहेरिटेंस यस और नो गाइस
यस सर
टिल नाउ इट इज हायरार्किकल And now when I create one more child D derived from B and C, child D which is derived from B and C, so now it becomes
hybrid,
multiple. I mean, till here it is multiple. From that side it is hierarchical, from this side it is multiple. And when both are involved, therefore we'll say hybrid. Okay, now I'm creating object of D class. So can D class access A's method, B's method, C's method and its own? See, it's accessing F also, G also, H also and P also. Here I didn't call them indirectly, but you can, which in the demonstration I gave you. In the demonstration I showed you. Okay. Okay. Now coming to the next concept, that is overriding. So all the basic types are clear to you, isn't it, guys?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
The basic types, like all the six types whatever I told, that are clear to you. Coming to the next concept, that is overriding. Always remember, overriding is applicable only for inheritance. Means where there is inheritance, there only overriding concept come. Means where inheritance is not involved, so you cannot use this word overriding. Correct? Because this overriding is concept associated with inheritance only. And don't confuse with overloading. Overloading and overriding, both are polymorphism features only. Clear? But overloading means there are set of functions or family of functions with same name and different signatures. Getting? Means I have defined one function def foo, but this is taking one argument. Another foo is taking two argument, which is actually not supported by Python, because Python never allows overloading. Overloading means what? You got it, no? Family of functions means there are many functions with the same name but different signatures. Signatures means prototypes. The prototypes are different, logic different, but the name same. You understanding? But this is not possible in Python, because Python doesn't support which feature? Function overloading. Right? Just remember, Python doesn't support function overloading principle. But overriding it allows. Now, overriding means when the method of a parent is redefined by the child. means child has taken the signature and the name from the parent, but algorithm it has given its own. Clear? Means in parent class there is one method foo. ठीक है? And in child class, like example B is derived from A, there is one method called foo only. So it is an overriding. Why overriding? Because child is redefining the parent method. Child is redefining the parent method. Means it has taken the name from the parent, signature also from the parent, but definition it has given its own. Logic, algorithm is its own. Getting? So overriding concept which happens in real life many times. I told you, na, like I gave a best example of marriage. So generation, the definition of marriage is changing. The name we are just carrying from the previous generation. Getting? Like 100 years back, like when they were samsthanics and all. So that time the marriage definition was 7 days late. After few years, the marriage definition changed to 3 days. After 1 day, and now in pandemic, it is hours only. Within 1 or 2 hours, the marriage happens. So according to the generation, the algorithm is changing, but the name is carried. Every generation is carrying the name, but every generation is giving its own definition, own algorithm. Getting? So I hope you got it. So example like vehicle is there, and for vehicle also there is accelerate. Clear? Vehicle accelerate. And then from that vehicle, if there is bike, so is bike also going to have accelerate? Yes or no? So bike will take the name accelerate, but algorithm it will give its own. Because the mechanism of accelerating a bike is different. And if there is a car, the car will also have accelerate. But the algorithm of accelerating a car and the algorithm of accelerating a bike is different. A bike is there is hand acceleration. Here it is leg acceleration. So obviously the algorithms of accelerating both are different. But are both taking the method same from the parent? Bike is also taking the same method, child is also taking same, but the algorithm it is giving its own. So that is called overriding. Okay? So I hope you got the quickly, I hope you have understood, sir, the concept of overriding. Clear?
Huh. Sir, we also saw two operators which were overloaded.
Huh. Operator overloading is supported, but function overriding is not supported. Function overloading.
Okay.
You're talking about overloading. So overloading, you can overload operators.
Operators. Okay.
But normal method overloading is not supported. Getting?
Okay.
And overriding you can do. Python
for
supports
both.
Overriding.
For both operators and methods.
Huh. But overloading of the operator only will do, correct? And methods can be overrided, correct?
Okay.
So when a method in a subclass has the same name and signature, but only the signature and the name is carried, okay? The definition is not, definition of its own it will put. So when a method in a subclass has the same name and signature as a method in superclass, then the method in the subclass is said to override the method in superclass. We'll say the subclass is overriding the method in superclass. Override means you're suppressing it. Means you're putting whom in the back? Parent, and who is coming in focus now? The child one. Correct? Which version of the method will be executed? That depends on the object which is invoking. And that's the reason it comes under runtime polymorphism. Like here example I gave you. Ki which accelerate will be called? Bike accelerator or car? Accelerate is a method, But whose will be called? That depends on whose object. Like, see, I have written O equal to bike. Means I created an object of bike class. Object of bike class is created, and I call O dot accelerate. And later I'm writing O equal to car, correct? And I'm writing O dot accelerate. Now, can you tell me in both contexts, ठीक है, both contexts is the name same? O equal to, as I said, bike, object of bike class created, reference collected in O, and I am calling O dot accelerate method, ठीक है? And after some time, I am writing O equal to, in O only, I am creating a object of car. And I am calling O dot accelerate. So can you see that in both the contexts, here also and here also, is the name exactly same? The signature is also same, the name is also same, but the code run behind it, that is the action, is same or different?
Different as per the invoker.
Yes, as per the object which is there. So in O, if there is a bike object, it's going to call bike accelerate. And in O, if there is a car object, it will call car accelerate. But still, shall we call it as polymorphism? Polymorphism means one name, many form. One name, but forms are, actions are different. As I said, na, Amitabh Bachchan. Amitabh Bachchan is polymorphic. Getting? He's our generation hero, na? There is a large gap, at least 25 years gap between you and me. And near about, Harshal is near about, like, but still, at least little gap. But others are too big gap. So for you people, your heroes are different. Our role models were different. So Amitabh Bachchan is the best example of polymorphic because he has played so many different types of roles in different movie. But entity is Amitabh Bachchan. But in context of movie, he is different. In which context, which movie context you are talking, his actions are different. Right? The same way here, accelerate, whose will be called? Bike accelerate or car? Depending on the object. Getting? So can I say it is polymorphic? One name. Correct? But different actions. Right? But shall I call it as a runtime polymorphism? Why? Because which method will be called? Bikes accelerate will be called or cars accelerate? That depends on the object, and objects are created when? At runtime.
And
Okay, so binding of this method with that call, binding of that method with that call, is it done at runtime? Means it's delayed till runtime. Runtime, the decision takes place. Whose accelerate will be called? Whether bikes accelerate or cars accelerate. That is totally depending on the runtime, whose object. Getting? So that is the main thing. Okay, so quickly I'll just give you an example. Now, can you see animal is a parent class? Dog is the child class of animal. Animal will have its own data, dog will have its extra data. But can dog access this animal's data also? Yes, indeed. Why not? Clear? Animal's data is also available and dog's own data. Correct? Now tell me, dog, can it access eat of animal? Can dog access eat of animal? Is eat method of animal available to dog?
Yes, sir.
Yes, and that's the reason I wrote na, inherited.
Yeah.
Inherited meaning which flows to the child. Anything which goes to the child means it is inherited. So dog can access eat. Getting? Then has dog defined its own method bark? Yes, it is extra its own method, which in real life also we get many things from parent, but we also have our intelligence, we also have our capability, so we people also add something of our own also, no? getting? The dog is having its own bark. And move method, should we say that it is overrided? Why? Because dog has taken the name move from animal, and that move is redefined in dog, and dog has given its own logic, but the name it has carried. So can we say move is overridden? In animal, move is overridden. Okay, and in child it is overrided.
Rided, okay.
Clear? So now tell me, if I create an object of dog class, so what all things dog can access? Can it access animals data?
Yes.
If
yes.
I create all. An object dog, D equal to dog. Okay, D equal to dog round bracket. I've created an object of dog. So that dog object can access animals data, dog's
Hello.
Own data.
Data,
it will access its own data also, animals data also.
Right.
Then can it access dog, can it access eat of animal?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Can it access bark of its own?
Yes.
Yes.
Can it access move of its own?
Yes.
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 And indirectly can it access move of animal? Directly
yes.
It cannot. But within this move, can it call animals move?
Yes, animal dot
yes.
Move.
Animals move. Can it access? Yes, which you said animal dot move and then self.
Yeah.
Getting? So you can do that. But there is another way also, I'll tell you. Okay? So I'll give you quickly one example of overriding. Then there is one concept called operator overloading. One operator overloading concept is remaining. Okay, see here. I'm taking one class F. In that, I'm defining one method F. Print I am in is F. Okay, then I'm creating one child class B derived from A. Here also, I'm defining one method F. Correct? In B also I am defining one method F. So first of all tell me, is it overriding?
Yes sir.
It is overriding.
Yeah.
Why? Because when you are redefining the method of parent in child, when parent method is getting redefined in child, that is concept called overriding. But now I want to access that parent F and child F also. Means I want this logic also, plus I want to add my logic. Means I want to access the parent logic reusability. Means I want to take the benefit of parent algorithm. This algorithm also I want to call, and I want to add my own as well. Getting? So now in this context, if you write self, it won't work. Previously, like if the name here is F and here it is G, okay, so there were two options. No? One, we were writing self.f. Was it working? Very first example of single inheritance which I gave you. See, this was one example of single inheritance. You remember or no? No, this is not example. This one, single inheritance. There I told how to access the parent method inside child. So one way is by writing parent name dot that method or self. But self will work when the name are different. When the names are same, it won't work. It will rather go into recursion. See, in parent the name is F and in child the name is G. And you are calling it this way, self.f. It will work. First, actually, self.f when you wrote. So, f it is going to search first in itself. First, it will search in B class. Now, in B class, it doesn't get f Therefore, it proceeds its search to A, and in A it is searching F. And in A, F is found, therefore it is called. But when there is overriding, then what will be the issue? Will it go into recursion? What do you say, guys? When I write self.f, so first where it is going to search that f?
In B class.
Yes, exactly, in B class. But first when it search in B, does it get in B only? Means, is it supposed to go to parent class for searching, or is the search completed in its own class only?
In its own class.
Yes, because in own class only f is present. So priority it will go to the nearest class. So will it keep calling its own f only again?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Yes. It will go into an infinite recursion. Getting? So in such case, when there is overriding, that time this way you cannot access the parent method. This is not the way. Self.f. So then what provision? So one which is a poor method. Why poor? I have told you already. A dot f, and then you can write self. Okay. Why I told you why this is a poor technique. Accessing the parent method in the child. Parent overrided method you access is in the child.
Dependency of the...
Yes. This it's called as a code dependency. Right? Means in the future, if the parent class name change, am I supposed to make lot of changes in the child class? In the child class, everywhere where a dot is used, I have to make change everywhere. You understanding or no? Correct? So to overcome this, they have given another technique. I'll tell you what that is. Now we'll just talk about this. See here, now B, B. Okay, you can create object of A class also. Tell me, if I write A dot F, and here if I write B dot F, which F will be called? Depending on the, just now on the slide also we have mentioned that line. See, which version of a method will be executed is determined by the object that is used to invoke it. Means in whose context you are invoking. Your example I gave you, like you are invoking accelerate. Here also you are invoking accelerate. But the object in whose context it is invoked, it depends on it. Now this object is containing car's reference, it will call car's accelerate. And here the object is containing bike's reference, it will call bikes accelerate. Same way here, now tell me, A is containing A's reference, so A is F. Clear? If you take a common object also, see here, X only, and X dot F. And here also again I am creating X and X dot B. Can we say it is polymorphism? Yes, see here, one name. Clear? But the action behind that is different. In both contexts, is the action same or is the action different? Now in this context, which F it is going to call? And in this context, which F it is going to call? Yes, guys?
First A, second B.
A's F, then B's
F. Okay. So in the first case, correct, it is going to call A's F. And in the second case, it's going to call B's F. Why? Because depending on the object. No? Here you have created B object. Here you have created A object. So which object? That class method is called. Okay? So okay, but here when B's F is called, inside that indirectly you have given call to A's F also. This is 16. Clear? See you. In the first case, it has called A's F. In the second case, it has called B's F. But in B's F, you have given call to A's F. Correct? Now, this was one way by writing parent class name dot. another provision, like if you don't want to reveal only whose name in the child class, parent name, means nowhere the significance of that parent name should come. Means parent name is not coming in any context. So that what benefit you'll get later if your parent name change, you don't have to make change in the child. So how to do it? So for that, there is another provision given. This I'll put it in comment. And the provision which is using one function called super. Super is again one function in Python. But that function, whereas in Java it's a keyword. Okay. Here it's a function which gives you the parent object. And once you get the parent object, you can access the parent method. Here you can write dot f. Clear? That's all. Here you don't have to write self. Why self is not needed? Because super is already returning home. Super function is already returning the parent object. And then that object is invoking f. You understanding or no? Clear? And this program also you'll run, the output is going to be same. But what benefit you will get by using this super function? Super function benefit. What you will get?
We can directly access the class A's function.
Huh, but the main benefit what you are going to get? Which I told you, like, about
poor.
The name. Huh.
So, will avoid the poor declaration.
Like what you say, that concept is called as independency, code independency.
Independency,
so
right.
Will this code be dependent now or independent code?
Independent.
Independent.
Why? Because if the name of A change, then also are we supposed to do any changes in the child class?
No.
There is no need to do. Clear? Instead of super round bracket f, if I would have written a dot f, so obviously this a name I have to change na, everywhere. But super refers to whom? Super round bracket, when you say na, it gives the access to the parent object. So super function will give you by default the parent method. Let the name of the parent be anything. Let the name of the parent be anything. It will bring and give you the parent object. And then access it method. Clear? So that is the benefit. We'll quickly take an example of overriding. See here, class A, it's F. Class B, which is also derived from A, and it is also having its F. So both class have defined same name method. So it is overriding. Isn't it? A equal to A, A dot F. So which F will be called? Depending on the object. The object is of A class, A is F. B equal to B and B dot F. So as the object is of B class, it will call B is F. Whose object you have created, it will call its methods. Getting?
Sir, this super function can be used in multi-level inheritance also.
Yes, yes. Means one parent and then you want to access. Now if there is one more child class, class C, which is derived from B, okay, and here also there is one F, correct? So now in this F I want to access the parent F. So here also you can write super dot F, getting? And then print I am in C's F. Clear? So this super round bracket will give access to its parent, that is B, and it's accessing the parent F, and in that again super, it will give access to its parent and its F. Getting? Again C. Here I'm writing X equal to C and X dot F. So as the object is of C class, it will call C's F. So in all three places, can you see the syntax is same? Yes or no? Can you see the name of the method is same, the signature is same, but the code run behind all three, is it same? Is it same or is it different? Yes, guys. The code run in context of this F, the code run in context of this F, and the code run in context of this F. Is it same or different?
Different.
Depending on the object, whose object you have created. Getting? So is it runtime polymorphism? Means is the concept called as polymorphism? Polymorphism means one name but different actions. Name is same but the actions are different. Clear? See here. Now it will give call to, when I give call to x dot f of in context of C object, it will call this, in which it is calling B's f, in which it is calling A's f. Therefore all three have come, A's f, B's f and C's f.